So hello learner, once again I welcome on the class of hydraulic engineering. So I hope you all are safe and good health. So in the previous discussion we have seen about the laminar sublayer, and after that I have discussed the Blasius equation. If the velocity profile is not given, then how to compute the boundary layer thickness. And after that I have discussed about the expression of local or frictional drag and average drag, and how to compute the drag force on one side of plate and both side of the plate. So today I will discuss about the when our flow is turbulent, then what will be the expression of local drag or frictional drag or average drag, and how to compute the drag force on one side of the plate and two side of the plate. And after that I will discuss about the when the flow is partially laminar and partially turbulent, then how to compute the drag force and what will be the expression of local and average drag coefficient. We will discuss today. So today I am going to discuss about the von Karman equation. Von Karman momentum equation according to von Karman tau naught by rho u squared is equal to d theta by dx. So this is the equation given by von Karman, and you must have studied in your fluid mechanics, where theta is the momentum thickness, u is the free stream velocity, tau naught is the shear stress, tau naught is the boundary shear stress. So according to von Karman, tau naught is equal to rho u squared d theta by dx. And after that I am going to discuss the turbulent boundary layer. So in laminar boundary layer we have seen the expression of delta by x. Similarly here we can see the delta by x is equal to 0.376 divided by rex to the power 1 by 5. But there is a condition when Reynolds number lies between 5 into 10 to the power 5 to the 10 to the power 7, and delta by x will change 0.22 divided by rex to the power 1 by 6 when our Reynolds number lies between 10 to the power 7 to 10 to the power 9. So this formula is applicable when our Reynolds number lies between 10 to the power 7 to the 10 to the power 9. Then we can apply this formula, otherwise this formula. Similarly, the expression of local drag CF. So CF is equal to 0.059 divided by rex to the power 1 by 5. But this formula is applicable when our Reynolds number is lies between 5 into 10 to the power 5 to the 10 to the power 7. Otherwise CF is equal to 0.37 divided by log 10 REL to the power 2.58. So this formula is applicable when our Reynolds number lies between 10 to the power 7 to the 10 to the power 9. Similarly, the expression of average drag coefficient CD. So CD is equal to 0.074 divided by RE to the power 1 by 5. And this formula is applicable when our Reynolds number lies between 10 to the power 7. Otherwise, we have to apply CD is equal to 0.456 divided by log 10 REL to the power 2.58. And this formula is applicable when our Reynolds number lies between 10 to the power 7 to the 10 to the power 9. So these are the expression of local drag and average drag. With the help of that, we can compute the drag force. Fd is equal to Cd 1 by 2 rho u square. So this is the expression of drag force. Cd is the drag coefficient or average drag, rho is the density, u is the velocity. So the total drag coefficient, total drag force can be computed by Fd is equal to Cd 1 by 2 rho u square a, where Cd is the drag coefficient, rho is the density, u is the velocity and a is the area. So this is the expression to compute the total drag force by when our plate is either completely laminar or completely turbulent. Now I am going to discuss when our plate has some portion laminar boundary layer and some portion has turbulent boundary layer, then how to compute the net drag. So in this case, I am going to analyze by this way. Let us assume D1 be the drag, assuming full plate to be turbulent. And subtract D2 is the subtract drag for turbulent condition in the portion of plate which is laminar. And D3 is the add drag for laminar condition for the plate length having laminar boundary layer. So net drag is equal to D1 minus D2 plus D3 will be the net drag. So when our plate has some portion laminar and some portion turbulent, then net drag will be D1 minus D2 plus D3. And in this case, the drag coefficient will be Cd is equal to 0.074 divided by REL to the power 1 by 5 minus 1700 divided by REL. So we have to use this formula when the plate has some portion laminar and some portion turbulent. But this drag coefficient formula is applicable when our Reynolds number lies between 10 to the power 5 into 10 to the power 5 to 10 to the power 7. And when Reynolds number varies between 10 to the power 7 to 10 to the power 9, then drag coefficient can be computed as 0.455 divided by log 10 REL to the power 2.58 minus 1700 divided by REL. So this is the expression of drag coefficient or average drag when our Reynolds number lies between 10 to the power 7 to 10 to the power 9 and plate has some portion laminar and some portion turbulent. So drag force can be computed by same formula Cd 1 by 2 rho u square. So in this case also only CD will change, and with the help of this formula we can compute the total drag force acting on the plate when our some portion is laminar and some portion is turbulent. So dear student, today I have discussed about the von Karman equation. According to von Karman, tau naught by rho u square is equal to d theta by dx, where tau naught is the boundary shear stress and theta is the momentum thickness, rho is the density, u is the velocity. And after that I have discussed when our plate has fully turbulent boundary layer, then we have seen the expression of local frictional drag and average frictional drag. And local frictional drag and average frictional drag depends on the value of Reynolds number. There are two cases I have discussed. When our Reynolds number lies between 5 into 10 to the power 5 to the 10 to the power 7, then expression of frictional drag will be different. And when our Reynolds number lies between 10 to the power 7 to 10 to the power 9, then expression of local frictional drag and average frictional drag will be different. And once we have computed the average drag coefficient, then we can compute the drag force on that plate by using the formula Fd is equal to Cd 1 by 2 rho u square A. And after that I have discussed when our when the plate has some portion laminar and turbulent, then how to compute the net drag we have discussed. And when the plate has some portion of laminar and some portion turbulent, then average drag coefficient expression I have discussed. When Reynolds number lies between 5 into 10 to the power 5 to 10 to the power 7, and it will be and another formula when our Reynolds number lies between 10 to the power 7 to 10 to the power 9. So average drag coefficient is equal to 0.455 by log 10 REL to the power 2.58 minus 1700 by REL. So in the next class I will discuss about the boundary layer separation, and after that I will take some problems based on the boundary layer theory. So take care of your health and happy learning. Thank you.